Hey folks, Nas here. Another episode of Medieval Dynasty on the Oxbow Map. Now I am in single player. I am not in co-op right now. I do plan on having special guests join me from time to time throughout this series. So that will definitely be a nice addition than what we've had in series past. So everything in series past has always been single player. But we are still in single player right now, but I am on the Oxbow map. As you can see behind me here, I have gotten the second house built as well. That way we can at least bring in one villager. I've gotten all the buildings that I'd placed, for the last episode. I've got them all finished. I worked through the night to make that happen. Used up the majority of my logs and everything. So there is that. But today, we are going to be doing something, a little bit of farming. I want to get some farm plots laid out. That way I can kind of start figuring out where I want to place like the farming buildings. Now, I've got my little village up there. I think I'm going to start putting farming plots out in this area here. And then I can have a barn up near the road. The road that I built, and then I can have a farm shed down in this area here. So I think what I want to do is I want to do like 9x5 farming plots. And the reason for that is I've noticed that the wooden hoe can hoe up 15 plots, 15 little squares before it breaks. So I know if I keep it on the 15s, it's easy for me to figure out how many wooden hoes right now I would need to actually completely, you know, grub and everything the field. So, or plow the field, because you'll need the three to grub the field, and then you're going to need the three hoes when you put down the fertilizer and you got to plow the field. So it's going to take 6 wooden hoes to do a 9x5 farming plot, which I think will give you a decent amount of vegetables or whatever you want to put in that. And then we can make several of them across this area, because there's a little road on the other side. So I think that's what I'm going to do. We're going to come up. We're going to pull up our crafting wheel. Q to pull up the crafting wheel or the building wheel. Go to buildings, go to farming, go to field. And then I'm going to kind of line up with the W so I don't hit the road. So I can see the little green marker in front of me. Line that up. Look at the W at the top of the screen. And then I can see that I'm probably not going to hit the road if I have to go up that far. Now, granted, I am standing near a rock, so I know I can't place it on the rock. And I want to be just off the roadway, so I think we're going to go here. Yeah, like that. So then I can come across here and figure out how far we can go, how many fields we can possibly have. Now, I know that this red right now, I'm not placing a whole thing. You can only place 16 long and 16 wide. But this tells me that I can potentially have 30 single plots all the way across here to kind of give me an idea of how I want to lay this out. So what I'm going to do is we're going to come back down here. We know that we can get all the way across there. The tree isn't going to be in our way or anything, and there didn't seem to be any mining nodes like this right here, rock nodes. So we're going to come up 9. There, 9. Yep. We didn't hit the road. Now, can we go the other way? We cannot, but I think we might be able to put a fence there. Possibly. You know what? Let's go down here. Let's scoot over one more. So like, let me pull that back up again. Like right here. Let's scoot over there. We'll just scoot over one plot. That way we have a little bit of room. If we wanted to put a fence over here, we can. So see, we can actually put something there. And then we're at 12. Let's go back to 9, and then we're going to come over 5, just like that. And then we can place that. Fields, yay, because we need farming points. We don't have any farming points. I haven't unlocked the barn or the farming hut or anything, farming shed, whatever. But I want to kind of go through here and lay out these plots, Because once we get somebody in here for farming, they can potentially just, as long as they've got the materials, lay these out as well, or finish plowing them as well. But we're going to go 5, and then we're going to go back down here and do 9. Let's see, there's 10, there's 4, and there's 5. So right there, that should be it. Everything should be lined up. You can see the little pegs. Everything is lining up. We got the little gap between. That should be good. And we can do another one. So these are all going to be like future plots, whether you're doing them or whether a villager is doing them. So again, we see the 9x5 down at the bottom of the screen. That tells you how big the field is. And then you can left click to place. Now, I don't have to have all of these fields here. What I'm doing is I'm making sure how they're going to be laid out across here, because I kind of have an envision in my head how I want them to be. But I want to make sure that they're going to fit properly, and I don't need to space them a little bit differently. So then we're going to come off of that one till it's green. And again, we're going to go 5, and then we're going to come up here with 9. Oop, that's 10. That's 4. 9, 5. There. And then place. And then we see that we've got a pretty decent chunk on this side for fencing. So what I could do is, we can actually probably scoot that over one more. How much room do we have here at the top? Yeah, we could scoot that over one more. So what I could do, how many do we have? We got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. You know what? I think I'm going to probably keep it like that. I think that'll probably be just fine. We can actually, if we wanted to, we could put a fence down here, and we can even widen this road if we wanted to a little bit, all the way down to that junction. That wouldn't be too bad either. But this allows us to get, how many more can we get up here? If we do another farm plot, how many can we get above this? So if we just go the one little thing, how much room do we have? Oh, we got enough room right here to get another 9, and then we can do the 5 again, and we should be able to go all the way across. At 16, it's going to turn red. And then, where's the marker? Yeah. So we can get a whole nother set of those in here. So what I could probably end up doing, were we able to get, how much were we able to get again? Yeah, I didn't see how much room do we have before we actually hit the road? That's what I want to see. How much room before we hit the road? Come right off of that. And we hit the road at 11. Yeah, 11 hits the road. Okay. If that's the case, how much space? Nope, that's not what I want. I want this. I'm going to put a marker on myself right here. Yep, 1 meter. That's good. And I want to come over here and see how big this area is. So you can see it over there. You can see the little blue marker on the far left of the directional bar at the top of the screen. And we have, where'd it go? 63 meters. Okay. Well, that's plenty good. So we can, in theory, put a farm shed down here. And it would reach, yeah, we got 52 meters to there. Because if it's still the 70 meters from the farm shed, then that's good. Then we can reach all of those and having a farm shed down here. Or up top. But I would think down here would be better, because then we can also add more farm plots down here as well, all the way down into this little area here. That would be good. Absolutely, that would be good. Now, what I'm going to do, actually, I think I'll just leave those there. We need to be able to start producing the fertilizer. So I think what we can do is potentially get cabbage seed, because it's summer. Cabbage seed will go in the ground in the summer. We've only got a couple of days of summer left, so we should probably run to town and grab, make sure that we've got plenty of cabbage seed and plenty of fertilizer, and try and get that in the ground. And what I'm thinking about is maybe going ahead and doing two plots full of cabbage. That wouldn't be too bad. So I'd have to hoe the two plots. Now I can probably leave these, so when I have somebody come in to work these fields, they can go ahead and finish plowing all of this up or grubbing it up and everything. So let's run into town. I still haven't found any thistle. I'm wondering if thistle isn't available until next season, which could be a thing, but I haven't like thoroughly looked for it, because what's that? That's henbane. That's going to be henbane. Oh, thistle. There's a thistle right there. Okay. Well, let's grab some thistle. Let me get my stamina back up. I don't remember how many thistle we needed for that one quest. There it is there. But it said we had the daisies on hand. St. John's wort. Stone. Thistle. Oh, thistle has the little purple flowers on the top. There it is. Okay. Let's grab these thistles. Grab that one there. We got six thistle. I say let's grab 10. I don't remember. One of them was 7, I think, and one of them was 5. I just don't remember which was which. But yeah, the thistle's got the little purple flowers on the top there. There's 9. What is that? That's henbane. No, that's chicory. There's the broadleaf. I'll pick that up. It's chicory. Don't want to get too close to the wisent. There we go. Thistle. That gives us 10 thistle. Do we have any more daisies? Probably should pick some of those up if we see them along the way. See a lot of broadleaf. But I probably have enough daisies. 17 broadleaf plantain on me. Okay, I'll keep an eye out for the little white tip flowers. Those are the daisies. And I'm going to head back to town. That way we can actually pick up that quest and then also turn it in, because I've already got the stuff for it. But that's a good way to do some of those quests. Go to or those missions on the notice board or whatever. Go look at them, see what they require. As long as it doesn't require you to actually kill an animal, then you can actually collect the stuff beforehand. If it's just collect stuff like sticks or stones or these flowers or whatever, go and collect the stuff, and then you don't have to worry about picking up the quest and forgetting to complete it. Then you're like, okay, I got all the stuff for this. I can just pick it up and turn it in right after I pick it up. Alrighty, here we go. Here's the notice board here. And then we have this behave or sober up. Let's see, it was 6 thistle and 5 daisy. We have 10 and 7. So that's going to give us 11 coin, and it's going to give us 50 dynasty reputation. But we can get it and clear it off the notice board. You can double click on it or hit F to accept it. Now we're going to go into the journal, and we're going to highlight it so we can find the guy we need to turn the stuff into, who is over here. Ah, it's the quartermaster. Good day to you, citizen. Let's see. Good idea with this potion of sobriety. I brought some things to help. Let's see. Our tavern keepers will be glad. Thank you in their name. You're welcome. Perfect. All right. So we got 11 more coin. Good deal. Now, let's see. Who sells the grain? You're not even a vendor. Why am I talking to you? We have a diplomacy skill. Diplomat, more dynasty reputation gained. Points gained. Effect stacks if taken also by other players. Okay. That would be pretty good. Romeo, 10% more affection points gained while flirting. Yeah. I'll go ahead and take the Romeo.
Living in a smaller village.
We can always take that, whatever that potion is that clears the points. We can try and get one of those later. Let's see. I believe this guy here has the cabbage seed. He sells 100 cabbage seed. What are we going to need? We're going to need 90 if we're going to do two plots, because I did them 45 each. And then we're going to need fertilizer. He does have enough fertilizer. How much is 90 fertilizer going to weigh? 45 kilograms. I'm going to be slightly encumbered, I think. Because I think I already have 40-something kilograms on me. Yeah, see, I'm at 48 kilograms, so I'm going to be kind of encumbered. Oh, but I have 14 meat. There's 2 kilograms, two, almost 3. Let's sort this by weight. What are some of my heaviest items here? 2 stone, the wooden shovel. I can sell. I can get rid of both of those. The meat. I've got stone, an extra stone axe, and I got 2 stone axes and 4 fishing spears. Okay, let's get rid of the fishing spear. I can craft stone axes. Let me go cook the meat. I'm going to sell this this wooden shovel. I can craft that. I may not.
No refund.
Yeah, I'm still going to have to get rid of the meat.
That it's been less than 2 hours.
I mean, I'm still going to be encumbered, but at least maybe I won't be encumbered by much. Let's go into the little sick house here and cook that meat up. Can we still use this? Yes, we can. Craft. Let's cook all of that roasted meat, and then we'll eat a little bit of something, and then we can sell that. There we go, roasted meat. Let's go in our inventory. Let's go ahead and eat a something. What are we down to? We're down to 60 food. I don't necessarily need to eat the cheese because it gives us like 50 food. Let's go ahead and eat this meat. 2 and 3. We'll eat one more just to go ahead and top us off. And let's go ahead and drink some water. There we go. That way hunger and thirst is already full. And then we can sell some stuff. Try and make a little more room. Where's this guy?
Okay. Only the best products here.
All right. We're going to go ahead and we're going to buy the 90 cabbage seed. If I have time in the season, I might go out and literally just like grab a ton of berries or something, because those will turn to rot over the season change, and then I'll have some for next season. Let's see. 90 fertilizer. It should be good. 45. So I'm encumbered by 6 kilograms is all I'm really encumbered by. Where's that meat? Let's go there. Let's go down to roasted fish meat. We're going to sell all of that roasted fish meat. So now I'm only encumbered by almost 4 kilograms, which isn't terrible. But is there something else that I could sell? Let's sort that by weight. Let's go ahead and just get rid of the stone. That's 2 kilograms there. And I'm going to get rid of one of these stone spears. And that should... Yeah, I'll just get rid of one of those stone spears. Or here, I'll get rid of the stone axe. I can craft a stone axe. I can't craft a stone spear. There we go. Now we're no longer encumbered. And I can craft a new axe when I get back to the village. Thank you! Which, I'm going to need to craft... wooden hose, and I'm probably going to need to go get some leather. Oh, I think I have a bag. Did I have a bag? I think I dropped it in my house. I think I've got one of those little cloth bags or something. But I'm going to head back to the village. I'm going to work on the farming overnight. I'm going to try and get all of that stuff done, and then I'll probably spend the next day tomorrow going out and gathering berries. Do I even see berries here? Yeah, see, there's some berries right up here. So you can go through and you can pick these berries and drop them on the floor for the season change, and they should change to rot. We're going to be testing all of this stuff to make sure everything either works or doesn't work the way it used to. That way I can let you guys know what's really happening. But I think we're going to call this an episode. I appreciate everybody joining me today. If you are liking these, definitely hit that like button. If you have not subscribed yet, please consider doing so. Special thank you to my members. You should be able to see them on the screen now. And we will see you folks in the next one. You take care and happy hunting.